They say more money, more problems. They say more money, more problems. Bring on the problems. Hey everybody, welcome to Trading Capital's exclusive analysis. It's currently March 2nd, and as we jump into the charts, in this video we're going to be discussing gold, Bitcoin, and natural gas, and maybe we'll touch base on some of the things that happened after hours. Now, starting with Bitcoin obviously saw a little bit of a down day today. There's basically 21 minutes left in this candle, but Bitcoin is trying to get a late day push to recapture most of those gains that it lost. Now, it is down roughly right now about 0.6%, but if you look at this daily chart pattern, this is all inside bar, a little bit of bearish consolidation that is occurring. Now, there is a short-term positive for Bitcoin, being the fact that you're still holding this key support and you're still inside of this initial surge up. The larger term pattern, you can see that we're still trading inside of this range and underneath this key trend line. Basically, this COVID blip was a one-off event, so it really was kind of a dip. You were very briefly down in that area, so it really drawing this trend line connecting these pivots in 2018, where we saw a real POW pivot connecting through this chop, connecting through your major summer low, connecting through the FTX collapse pivot. You can clearly see that Bitcoin is really struggling at this resistance points. It's basically chopped around this range, tested it once, had a hard reversal, shot up again after tagging support here, and it's been reversed off of that level again. And the thing that concerns me about the price action of Bitcoin was, here was your initial reversal, here was your massive attempt at recapturing this bullish trend, and you could not confirm above this pivot over here. Even after multiple days and a couple weeks of price action, you've still yet to confirm above this original reversal candle. And then, to make matters worse, once you did have an attempt at piercing through, you had another daily hammer reversal candle. So lots and lots of wicks tells me that there's lots and lots of sell side pressure. So I would just caution people that this pattern still needs more consolidation on the daily to move higher. I still think we're going to get a move down, basically again to retest the support zone. It would likely coincide with these pivots around here, but that's kind of what I'm waiting for in Bitcoin, and based off of the longer term trend. So this is where it's key to look at the longer term picture. So if we look at the weekly chart of Bitcoin, the weekly pattern is actually okay. You're trading inside of this weekly reversal, bullish reversal, so this is still technically all bullish consolidation. Now, you are trading at the upper end of the range at resistance, so there's going to be clearly a lot of consolidation that needs to occur before you can actually challenge and move higher. Now, the thing that concerns me from a technical standpoint, which is why we're going to throw on the moving averages, starting with the 50 weekly moving average, look where we're trading into. This purple trend line right over there. You can clearly see we were rejected over here, we were rejected again over here, and basically we have tagged it this week and sold off of that level for a third time. So clearly there's resistance at that 50 week. This is a big long-term moving average, which we really haven't tested until we got rejected over here. And being the fact that you're still technically slightly overbought and you're into this resistance, it needs to work this overbought condition off to potentially move higher. Now, let's say you do get through that, looking at the 200, you're also below the 200. So that's what's another concerning aspect of this overall trend. Because the longer you stay below this blue 200 weekly moving average, this will slowly eventually start to slope down. And then when you look at the 100, this is what's concerning. The 100 is truly the one that I love to pay attention to for many sectors and different asset classes. And the 100 weekly moving average is now starting its sine curve rotation down. This trend, the fact that it's starting to slope down, is very, very bearish in the overall longer term picture. Bitcoin has never seen this moving average start to slope down because it hasn't had a long enough trend to really maintain and establish itself, at least on this chart, perhaps on the futures or the BTC USD chart. It may. But needless to say, once you have this trend sloping up, just like it started to slope up here, you got this massive rally. And notice the power of this trend line. As you were starting to basically slope up, 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 you got this huge push up in price action. And now this trend is on the verge of potentially sloping down. So what does that mean? It means that we're likely going to see continued weakness. Now let's jump into the intraday action because I do think Bitcoin is very fascinating. Basically, Bitcoin was trading down all day, all day, all day, all day. And then that last little market rally, hoorah, with a softening and a bit of the dollar and yields, you saw Bitcoin make another attempt. Flipping on the hourly chart of Bitcoin, the big level that I'm watching is basically this trend line over here. You can see we've struggled at it, basically bounced here twice. This is your breakdown point. You've retraced, got rejected. You retraced again, got rejected. That's your big level in the sand. If for some reason you get through that, you'll have another downsloping trend line over here that you'll need to first get through. So there's two levels, basically resistance one, resistance two. If Bitcoin can get through those two, then you likely will see at least a move up to this pivot around 24.6 and maybe a move back up to the all or the cycle high over here. So that's kind of the expectations for Bitcoin. I'm still slightly bearish just over the longer term trend, and being the fact that it has had a substantial move to the upside into this upper end range, I am finding it very difficult to see that Bitcoin is likely going to see more upside in the near term, just based off of many other market signals that we're receiving across different sectors and assets. Let's jump into gold. Gold, gold, gold. So first off, I'll take off all of the moving average just to start this. We can see we clearly identified this first level. This was a couple while ago. Our members had this information very, very privy to them. But needless to say, gold bounced off our 1827 though, had your initial reversal, and then you actually still went lower. But you can see that it's, this 1827 is a big support level as you've had a lot of price action and chop around this area, and it's currently being defended. I'm still in the camp. This was just a minor bounce in gold. Gold still has to hit more of the major levels to the downside, but gold did hit its upside objective, which we actually shorted. We've covered our gold short already. I do expect more downside, but a lot of the risk to reward is now out. I'm still looking to buy gold as well. There's another downside target around 1788 that I think is very likely, but I do think gold even breaks that level lower. Let's take a look at the longer term picture on gold. Basically, if we throw on the 100 and the 200 and the 50, you can clearly see gold 200 is in an uptrend, massive uptrend, which is very, very bullish for it. And then it's hugging this 150. So you can clearly see it's at long-term great technical support. But based off of other market conditions, I still think gold is going to pierce these moving averages and likely make a test these lows down here. So again, there's going to be an opportunity to buy gold, but I don't think it is yet. I think there's going to be a little bit more downside. I've definitely got my levels planned out where I plan to accumulate gold and a few other gold stocks. So there's definitely going to be a lot of opportunity to seize when the time is right. But the timing is going to be very critical in the specific asset class. Let's take a look at natural gas because it has been a complete powerhouse as of late. Even after today, you had a brief consolidation day. Just look at the sheer power of natural gas. You had a dip and natural gas closed basically back near the highs, recovering most of the loss. So you're really not getting daily consolidation, even though this technically is, and this is healthy. This is what we want to see because we're long nat gas, we're deep in the money already. But this type of consolidation is extremely healthy. And when you start seeing these tails forming intraday, it just means short covering is, again, likely happening. I still think this chart is primed to see a epic short squeeze. I've called that out. I've discussed that with our members. We've been accumulating natural gas at the lows and we're well positioned to benefit from this very, very likely move to the upside. Basically, I would still love to see maybe one or two more days of consolidation before we attack this 50. And then you'd likely see some consolidation off that and then try to make a move higher. My end goal is still hasn't changed. Natural gas is still very, very bullish in my mind. It's still one of the more safer commodities and sectors and assets to invest in right now, just due to how oversold it is and just what we're going through in the overall financial system with the bond market repricing, the Dixie, and a bunch of variety of different other sectors and asset class. But really, it would be very, very beneficial. But again, any sort of dip in buyback is currently being bought, and short coverings are likely starting to cover into that, which is why we're starting to form these wicks. But we really haven't seen much short covering yet. Take a look at the UNG. UNG is almost trading up to the 919. It actually finished positive in the after hours, which is certainly good to see. UNG's first big resistance, obviously, you hit this gap. I still think that this level will likely hit around probably within the next week or two. And by that time frame, you'd likely have the 50 daily moving average bearing down on you. So that'll be some minor resistance. But just due to the overall long-term signals, I mean, look at this monthly on UNG, this monthly bottoming tail. That is a epic reversal signal. That really is a rare signal. You don't often see monthly bottoming tails of that proportion frequently, especially when look at the amount of volume it's been on. I mean, just an astronomical amount of volume. So that is certainly healthy to see. I mean, I don't think we've really ever seen a monthly bottoming tail of that in terms of that reversal of that long of a wick, ever in the UNG price action. I mean, you had a little bit of a monthly reversal here, but it's not a bottoming tail. You could constitute that this was a potential hammer reversal, but certainly not as powerful as the one that we received. And just to put it in perspective, I mean, look at this little reversal. We still had from basically the high end of the candle, 36% upside in UNG on that simple little reversal. If you take a 36% move off of this high, I mean, let's just see where that puts us. Basically, 36% to the upside puts us right at around 1252. You can see its resistance at these pivots, so that would make sense as a big time resistance. But I still think that we can come up to this $14 on UNG. Needless to say, if you're not on this trade yet, it's literally I'm watching it unfold intraday, and I do think it's going to make a move up past these next pivots very soon. That is my expectations. On that note, let's just quickly jump over Costco. Costco reported earnings. It is down trading 475, so it's basically negated this whole rally that it had, and it's now closed at 475.80, which is just at the pivot low over there. You did have AVGO also report earnings. They're slightly up. You had HPQ, I believe, reported as well. They're basically, I think, we're down slightly in the after hours. You also had AI, which is blasted higher. I mean, 2503 on watch for another breakout to the upside. Again, these AI stocks are still overbought, but you're clearly seeing the momentum continue in these AI stocks, and it's certainly an impressive move. I mean, from the fact that you had a massive move in the after hours all the way up to about 19, 18, 19% to the upside. That's an astonishing move to the upside. So the earnings are kind of a little bit muted, but net negative. The S&P did finish slightly down in the after hours around 397.10. Overall, that's going to sum it up for today's video. If you're interested in other trade setups and more valuable information, please visit our website at tradingcapital.ca, where I do believe everyone can likely benefit from the information and educational material that we are continuing to offer and put out. On that note, I wish everyone a wonderful evening.
They say more money, more problems. They say more money, more problems. Bring on problems.